SMTC 2, The Snow Show.
And athletically demanding sport in the world, or is it just a lot of mustachioed wine bar hounds slithering around in some snow on two planks of wood? Well, this is the place to find out, because over the next 6 weeks, here in the perpetual winter wonderland of the Snow Show, we'll be bringing you ski stories from around the globe. The world's best skiers in the top resorts. There's action, adventure, thrills, terror, controversy, sex and violence. And that's all just in a feature on goggles.
Oh, stop it, Muriel. This week, we take tea and buns with the Cresta Club. All you need to know about moguls. Whoops, we're in for a bumpy ride. We speak to heli-skiing funny man Norman Lovett and get a lesson from Grumpy George.
St. Moritz is probably the most famous ski resort in the world. It was a spa town in the 19th century until the British upper classes discovered that they could have as much fun squandering their inheritances in winter here as they could in summer. And although the sun has thankfully set on the great British Empire, here in St. Moritz there's one small outpost which will be forever England.
I'm running into Gothenburg, picking up speed, very fast, now, into traffic clock.
And this is where the Union Jack still flutters optimistically over a long tunnel of sheet ice where gentlemen come to join the Cresta Club.
My name's Ron Diggle and I've been doing this business for about the last 40 years on and off.
Well, I don't know how I'll get on. I'm trying a new toboggan for the very first time.
I think you go round one corner right and another corner right. It's a very, very nasty left.
The Cresta Run, famous the world over for epitomising the speed and thrill of winter sports, was in true Alpine tradition started by the Brits.
The run was built first in 1885, and then, of course, was a very much more primitive, almost like a toboggling down a road, and gradually the banks were built more carefully.
And next came the traditional Swiss clubhouse.
This is an old cricket pavilion made by Bolton and Paul, brought over from England.
How did you get it over here?
By ship and rail.
And they're even kind enough to let Johnny Swiss join in.
You know, our national character is rather very serious and so, and it cheers us up. It gives us some oxygen for the rest of the year when we mingle with the British. And rather delightful, and, well, we just love it.
You'd never know the club was in Switzerland and run as it is like an English public school sports day, with orders being barked out at members over the tannoy by the formidable Colonel Willoughby.
I've got even tougher this year because we had a group of beginners who came out and they had a little, they ignored my advice, and I'm very tough with them. Well, the first chap to hospital wasn't bad, he just broke his arm in three places, but the second chap had a kidney removed. So that is exactly why I am tough.
Yeah, one chap downstairs described you as a prep school headmaster. I mean, you are quite intimidating.
What's wrong with prep school headmasters? Damn fine people. They produce quite a few decent British people.
Quite, and exactly the sort of good eggs they want as members. So if you haven't been to prep school, you can always try pretending you have. Which just might help you blend in amongst the chaps. Now, the Snow Show takes you places you've never been before, and today we're in the hallowed halls of the changing room of the Cresta Club. This is the Crest Club.
Hi, what are you doing? No, I'm sorry. No, absolutely not.
But why?
No, sorry.
I'm from television. Yes, you're welcome to apply for membership, unless you're a woman, because this isn't just a sporting club. This is a gentleman's sporting club.
Ladies were stopped in the 1920s, and though I wasn't around at the time, this was done on medical grounds, because the crossbar of an old-fashioned toboggan does come straight across your chest, and the run used to be a lot bumpier. And you really did. I mean, even the days I remember back in the 1940s and 50s, you really did have very large bruises across your chest fairly permanently.
That's only if you was like Samantha Fox. I mean, I wouldn't have any trouble at all. I think
it would be very difficult to have a rule that ladies, whether or not ladies could be elected, depended upon their vital statistics, wouldn't it?
Well, very surely all that cushioning stop you from being bruised.
Well, this was, I can't be expected to justify or not the decisions made in the 1920s.
Well, girls, you're probably not too upset that you can't sample the odour of old army underpants, or indeed join these fellows who've come from every corner of the House of Lords to compete in the annual Seniors' Cup.
Welcome to Cresta Sedalias.
There are a lot of very good riders in this, although they're all over 50. You know, some very good... I mean, Nino Bibbia has just gone now as a former sort of Olympic... You know, he won the Olympic gold medal in 48. I mean, he's... So there are a lot of very good riders.
Do you have to have a kind of regime the night before, like a boxer before you fight, like no drink or anything like that?
No. The more the merrier, usually.
Can I feel your heart?
First rider in the seniors.
And this is what it's all about. For those of you without titles or testicles, here's a glimpse of what these gentlemen gladiators get so excited about.
I'm starting off down the Jackson Straight. I'm picking up speed very rapidly now. I'm coming into rise. This is the easy bit. These are the easy ones. I'm coming into rise. I'm fairly late in rise. I'm coming into battle door, picking up speed very fast. There. Into shuttlecock. Pushing like mad in shuttlecock. Round shuttlecock. Into stream. Run. Down the straight. Gathering speed rapidly now. Holding off the banks, coming into profits on left-hand side, flat out now, 70 miles an hour, into center, caught this, down the crest to leap, 80 miles an hour, preaching finish, full finish, on the finishing back, coming to a rest now. We've made it. Thank God that's over.
Well, despite the good humour of these decent British chaps, the Cresta Run is actually quite dangerous, and with brittle old bones travelling at 70 miles per hour inches above the ice, well, accidents will happen.
Well, that's the most notorious part of the course, called the shuttlecock, and this viewing platform is called, rather aptly, the vulture pit. But of course, we wouldn't like to stand here and watch the cream of English gentlemen come to grief there, would we?
As you come along here, you want to get right up towards those bushes. If you're here, you're going to be in trouble.
I just was going too fast. I lost control in the shuttlecock.
I mean, you must realise how dangerous it is now. I mean, would you ever ride again?
Oh, yes, I'd be here next year.
But you could die.
Well, it's best to get hold of you.
So what is it that makes these dear old gents leave the security of the home counties, travel all the way to Switzerland just to dress up like their head gardeners and risk grazing their family jewels on the Cresta Run?
It's just a marvellous atmosphere, wonderful amateur sport.
No sort of smells, no noise.
We had one man who went down naked once, that was quite amusing.
The Cresta Club is public school without matron, the army without bully beef, a homestead from Hampstead, but most of all a cosy reminder that for a few weeks a year, a chap can be in chap heaven.
As soon as I leave here, when I've staunched the ghastly financial hemorrhage, I then start looking forward to coming out again next year.